In this video, we're continuing on with the Simplifying Radical Expressions worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now, before we get started, here's just a friendly reminder that if you've been finding my videos useful, please click that subscribe button and show your support. Now, on to number 11. In number 11, there's a perfect square that's a multiple of 75. And that perfect square is 25. 75 equals 25 times 3. And 25, we know, is 5 squared. So 5 squared times 3 equals 75. So I'll rewrite this square root in number 11 as a square root of 5 squared times 3 times x squared times y. Now in the first problem on this video, I'll break up this square root. However, just remember that a square root will cancel out an exponent of 2. But for now, I'll rewrite this as the square root of 5 squared times the square root of 3 times the square root of x squared times the square root of y. Now that square root will cancel out those exponents of 2, so I'll be pulling out a 5 and an x from within that radical. Therefore, 5 times x times the square root of 3 times y is my solution in number 11. 5x times the square root of 3y. And number 12, 64 itself is a perfect square. 64 I can write as 8 squared. And m to the third, remember the law of exponents, m to the third is equal to m to the 2 plus 1, which is m squared times m to the first, or simply m. So for m to the third and n to the third, I'll write each of those as m squared times m and n squared times n. So remember, my square roots will cancel out with those exponents of 2, so I'll just pull out the bases. So I'll pull out 8, m, and n, and under my radical, I'll still have m and n. So I'll have 8, m, n, times the square root of m times n. That's my solution in number 12. In number 13, I know that 16 is a perfect square. So I'll rewrite 16 as 4 squared, and u to the fourth, I can rewrite as u squared squared, because u to the 2 times 2 is u to the 4. Remembering my law of exponents, when I raise an exponent to another power, they will get multiplied together. So this will be u to the 2 times 2, and then v to the third, I'll rewrite as v squared times v. And if you're confused on why I wrote u to the fourth as u squared squared, refer back to the previous video, the last problem I did, number 10. I went over three separate ways to write an exponent to the fourth. One of those other ways being u squared times u squared. However, if you're taking the square root of that, when you cancel out those exponents with that radical, you'll be left with u times u on the outside, which will eventually give you u squared. But in this case, I'm going to be pulling out 4 and pulling out u squared and then pulling out a v, pulling out the bases of my exponents of 2. And u squared in its entirety is a base. So I'll have 4 times u squared times v times the square root of what's left under that radical, which is v. So 4 u squared times v times the square root of v is my solution in number 13. So if I would have wrote u to the fourth as u squared times u squared, when I canceled out those exponents, I would have pulled out bases u and u, which would have given me u squared. So that's just another way to think about number 13. Let's continue on to number 14. In number 14, my whole number is 28, and I know that 28 has a perfect square of 4. 4 times 7 is equal to 28, which 4 we can rewrite as 2 squared. So 2 squared times 7 is 28. So I'll rewrite this entire radical as the square root of 2 squared times 7, and then rewriting x cubed as x squared times x, and rewriting y cubed as y squared times y, since y squared times y is y to the third, and x squared times x is x to the third, I'll be able to pull out my bases with exponents of 2. So that will be 2, x, and y. And then what's left within my radical will be 7, x, and y. So I'll have 2, xy times the square root of 7xy. That's my solution in number 14. In number 15, 36 is already a perfect square. So I'll rewrite 36 as 6 squared, and x squared I will leave as x squared since it has an exponent of 2, and y to the third I will break up so it will have an exponent of 2. So there will be y squared times y to the first, or simply y. So I have 3 separate bases that have an exponent of 2, that's 6, x, and y. So I'll pull out 6, x, and y, and then I'll multiply that by the square root of y. That's my solution in number 15. Moving on to number 16, I'm looking at this whole number 384. 384 is divisible by 4. That's 4 times 96. However, 96 is also divisible by a perfect square. 96 is divisible by 4. So 4 times 4 times 24, since 4 times 24 is 96, and when we multiply that by 4, that's still equivalent to 384. However, I'm not done yet in finding that largest perfect square that goes into 384, because 24 can be rewritten as 4 times 6. So I'll have 4 times 4 times 4 times 6, and that's equal to 384. Now remember, there's a rule that says perfect squares multiplied together will be a perfect square. So if I multiply 4 by 4 by 4, I'll get 64. So 4 times 4 times 4 is 64, and that's multiplied by 6, which is 8 squared times 6. So my largest perfect square that goes into 384 is 64, since I multiply my perfect squares together to get 64, and 64 is 8 squared. So I'll rewrite 384 as 8 squared times 6. That way I'll be able to pull out an 8. And then x to the fourth, I'll rewrite that as x squared squared, and then y to the third, I'll rewrite that as y squared times y. So now I'll be able to pull out 8 and x squared, and then y. So I'll have 8 times x squared times y times the square root of 6 times y, because 6 and y are left. And when I take the square root of a number squared, the square root of 8 squared is 8, the square root of x squared is x squared, and the square root of y squared is y. So 8 times x squared times y times the square root of 6 times y. Now number 17, we're introducing a new number, and that number is outside of the radical. However, that does not change the method, we just have to remember to multiply what we pull out by 7. So that number within the radical, 96, I know the largest perfect square that goes into 96 is 16, because 96 is 16 times 6, and 16 is 4 squared. So I'll have 7 times the square root of 96, which is 4 squared, times 6, and then I'm still multiplying that by m to the third, which I will rewrite as m squared times m. So now I'll be able to pull out my 4 and my m. So I'll have 7 times 4 times m times the square root of 6m, because 6 and m are still within my radical. Now I'll simplify. 7 times 4 is 28. So I'll have 28m times the square root of 6m. That's my solution in number 17. So again, this 7 that's outside of the radical will get multiplied to what I pull out of my radical. Let's continue on to number 18. The whole number 72 within the radical, I know right off the bat that 72 is divisible by a perfect square, and that largest perfect square that it's divisible by is 36. And that's 36 times 2, so I can write that as 6 squared times 2. So number 18, I'll rewrite as 6 times the square root of 6 squared times 2 times x squared. So I'll be pulling out a 6 and an x from my radical. So that'll be 6 times 6 times x times the square root of 2. 6 times 6 is 36, so I'll have 36x times the square root of 2 as my solution in number 18. In number 19, 150, the largest perfect square that is a multiple of that, is 25. So 150 is equal to 25 times 6. So that's 5 squared times 6 is equal to 150. So I'll rewrite number 19 as negative 6 times the square root of 5 squared times 6 times r. So I'll be able to pull out 5 since the square root will cancel out that exponent of 2. So I have negative 6 times 5 times the square root of 6r. Negative 6 times 5 is negative 30. So my final solution will be negative 30 times the square root of 6r. And lastly in this video, we'll go over number 20. At number 20, my 80 that's within the radical, the largest perfect square that goes into 80 is 16. 80 is equal to 16 times 5, and I know that 16 is 4 squared. So 4 squared times 5 equals 80. So number 20 I'll write as 5 times the square root of 4 squared times 5 times a squared. Now, going more in depth with number 20, I'll go ahead and split up this square root so you can see how the square root of a number squared is that base. So we'll have 5 times the square root of 4 squared times the square root of 5 times the square root of a squared, in which the square root of 4 squared is 4 and the square root of a squared is a. So I'll have 4 times a times 5 outside, so 5 times 4 times a, and I'm left with the square root of 5. So 5 times 4 times a times the square root of 5. 5 times 4 is 20, so I'll get 20a times the square root of 5 as my solution in number 20. If you haven't done so already, remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Also, if you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if you think that you know somebody that will benefit from this video, feel free to share it with them. Continue on to the next video where I'll finish out this worksheet completing numbers 21 through 30.